In this video, I'll look at bringing objects between 3ds Max scenes using Merge, and different formats we can work in. I've got open my scene, 04 Station Start, and I'll press T for top view, Z to zoom extents, and F3 for wireframe. What we can see here in our scene are a couple of things. There's the main station, and right now we're looking down through the ceiling. It's got two platform tunnels coming off it, and the blue shell outside that keeps the light outside. That way the sun comes in through the windows, which we'll handle later. I've got the ticket booth off to one side, and this down here is actually a clock. There's the text up on top here, which will become the signs later. However, there's no seats, so we need to bring that in, and there's also no light fixtures yet. It's very common, and in many pipelines, both film and game, to work in multiple Max scenes and bring them together at a certain point. We'll see this especially on collaborative projects, where one team might be roughing out animation, where another part of the team is building assets for the environment, and so we can work in different files and sync them up. For now, I'm going to choose the simplest route. I'll click on the Max icon and choose Import. When we work in Max, we work in a .max file, a Max scene. We can import non-native formats if we need. For example, you may have a DWG coming in from AutoCAD or something similar. We can also bring in things that are translation formats, such as OBJ. Merge, then, takes objects between 3ds Max files. Replace, as it says, replaces objects in a 3ds Max scene, allowing us to work with proxies, boxes in place of maybe benches, as the benches are being built. If you'd like to work in Revit or Motion Builder or Mudbox, you can link through an FBX file to those applications and also to AutoCAD. For now, we'll just choose Merge. And it takes us right to that Scenes folder. I'll scroll down and choose Seating. I'll click Open. And Max pulls up a dialog asking us what we'd like to bring in. In this case, what we've got here in this Seating file are two photometric lights I've used just for working, just so I could see what I was doing while I was making the benches. Then there's a group here, shown by its brackets, called Seating Cluster. I'll select it and click OK. Notice that merging is very selective. We can choose only what we want to come in versus bringing everything. I'll click OK, and right here, halfway in and halfway outside of the wall, is a seating cluster. Four seats with arms, nicely made of leather and wood, and fitting the design style of the train station. I'll press Z to zoom extents, and Alt and the mouse wheel to spin around and take a look. And there's my seating. I need to bring in some chandeliers as well. And I'll click on the Max icon again, choose Import and Merge, and down at the bottom of the Scenes folder, I'll pick Chandelier. Again, I made these in separate files for easier working, so I could get one object done and make it around 0, 0, which is very common. So I had greater flexibility in how I built it, with the idea of bringing it into the main scene later. I'll click Open, and there's Chandelier 001. Again, this is a group of objects as shown by the brackets here. I'll click OK, and there's a chandelier. Again, somewhat submerged in the wall, and actually in the middle of the seating. We're not bound by physics unless we'd like to be, so we can have things really pass right through each other. In practice, I try not to do this too much, as it makes for more complicated lighting. But while we're merging things in, it's okay. With my objects merged in, I'm ready to start placing things. We need to place a bunch of seating, put chandeliers on all the ceiling pieces here, and get the ticket booth over on the side wall with a clock above it. Then we need to think about materials and finally light this scene. But merging together the pieces is important first. If you'd like to explore further beyond merging, and especially if you're working on a team project, 3ds Max is renowned for its reference system. Again, under the Max icon, we can look at references. And in references, we can bring in containers, ways of encapsulating objects. We can XRef objects, taking objects from one scene into a current scene, or bringing a scene around an object. It's very common to use both workflows, and depends on what you're doing. You could have a character, for example, that we bring the environment around, or we could have things like the seating that we reference into the scene once, and then duplicate the reference. so if we change one, they all change. If you'd like to explore that further, the 3DS Max help goes into referencing in good detail. For now, though, we'll just merge these objects in, so everything exists in one 3DS Max scene. Then we'll get started placing these and snapping them onto the ceiling and the floor.